Yeah, now we are sharing the screen here and we will start the class. Yesterday we discussed the concept of the digital signal processor starter kit. That was the DSK. And previously, previous to this class, we have also gone through the concepts of the DSP, means what are the basic features of the DSP, what are their advantages, disadvantages. And then we had discussed about the here the architecture of the digital signal processor, and specifically we have considered one digital signal processor that was named as the TMS320E6713, and that is the Texas Instruments processor having the speed of the 225 megahertz, and it was the floating point processor here. Now we will discuss here the some concepts of the TMS320C6713 DSP starter kit, because yesterday we had discussed that if we had developed the algorithm, then that developed algorithm has to be downloaded on a given target in order to test the performance of our design algorithm. And for that purpose, we had also discussed that there is a need of the IDE, Integrated Development Environment. And for this purpose, we are using the CCS Code Composer Studio. And yesterday, we have also gone through the introduction of the kit, that is the TMS320C6713 DSK, that is known as the Texas Instruments TMS320C6713 Digital Signal Processor Starter Kit. And in abbreviated form, it is named as the DSK, and it is designed and optimized to perform digital signal processing operations. And for short, this DSP kit is referred to as the C6713, and the family of this digital signal processor is referred to as the C6X, or sometimes we call it the family of the C6000. The C6713 is a high performance 32-bit floating point digital signal processor having the speed of the 225 megahertz. And as we have discussed during the time of the discussion of the features of the DSP processor, that it has the VLU architecture. VLU architecture is very long instruction word architecture that exploits the property of the parallelism at the instruction level. It has the low cost, it is a low cost standalone development platform that enables users to evaluate and develop application for the TI67 families DSP processors here. Now, the why we are discussing this topic in order to get the get familiar with the some concepts like an overview of the functional blocks of the board, and this board is the Texas Instruments TI. TMS320C6713 DSK board. And we have also interested, we are also interested in order to aware with the Code Composer Studio. And after getting the awareness with these two, that is the about the board or the kit as well as the ID Code Composer Studio, we will here try to learn the writing, compiling, and running a simple code so that we can program the here the algorithms which have been designed for the special purposes or the application. Yesterday we have also discussed that the block diagram of the TMS320C6713 DSK processor looks like in this manner. Here, if we see, then we will find that this processor, this is the processor here, the TMS320C6713 DSP processor, that is the digital signal processor. And the purpose of this processor is to interact with the real world. And now this processor can interact with the real world either in the analog mode, that is the analog input, and after processing, it will provide the analog output, or the digital interaction, and that is the digital input, digital output, and in the form of the data. So for these purposes, there are the three types of the ports here which are available in order to interact with the DSP processor. For the purpose of the analog inputs and analog output, there is a need of the coding and decoding. So along with the AIC23 codec, the mic in, that is the, here the we can consider the sound as the input, and the line in, these are the inputs here, mic in and line in, and these signals are given to the processors, and after processing we can get here the output in the analog form, that is the line out and HP, that is the headphone output. So these are the four ports, that is the mic in, line out and HP out. These are the four ports which are here available for the analog communication. And whatever this is the signal that is coded, decoded, and then there is again a peripheral expansion here. And the peripheral expansion is a facility to expand the facilities in order to interact with other channels. And these channels may communicate with this processor also. So if we see, then we will find there are the two channels. One is the this one through the AIC codec, and the second one is the through expanded peripherals here. So both channel signals are first multiplexed here. And after multiplexing, they communicate with the multiplexing, demultiplexing, they communicate with the DSP, digital signal processor. One more. Now come to the second one, that is for the purpose of to connect with the computer, as well as to connect here the JTAG, joint text action group. For these purposes, there are the two ports of the JTAG, joint text action group. One is the embedded JTAG and the second one is the external JTAG. Embedded JTAG is used to connect with the PC here, and this port is the USB port here, and this is the embedded JTAG, and this is the external JTAG. Now the two channels or the two signals will again be multiplexed here with the help of another multiplexer, and after multiplexing and multiplexing, they will communicate to the DSP processor. The first multiplexer, this one is known as the MCBSP, that is named as the multiple channel buffered serial port. Yesterday we have discussed this one, and this is also a multiplexing, and this is known as the MCASP, multiple channel audio serial port. So two types of the multiplexing are taking place here, and the third communication mode is through the LED and DIP switches in order to interact with the digital data, digital information here. Now if we come to the digital processor here, then as we know, for any digital device there is need of the DC biasing. For the purpose of this one here, the power port is available, and this power port is connected to the voltage regulator, and this voltage regulator gives the two ranges of the voltages. One is the 1.26, another is 3.3 volt here, and these are given as input to the DSP processor here. Now in order to connect the host port here, there is a host port interface, and this is connected to the this bus, that is known as the HPI, host port interface bus here. In order to connect the other memories and the flashes here, there is a external memory interface, and this external memory interface is connected with the CPLD, that is the complex programmable logic device flash, and the SDRAM, and there is a provision of the memory expansion having the 32 bit word length. And this is the block diagram of this kit, that is the digital signal processor starter kit, in which the digital signal processor is the core, and it is on a board along with the all peripherals that are required in order to communicate with the real world. So it is named as the TMS320C6713DSK. DSK means digital signal processor starter kit, and the name of the main processor is the TMS320C6713, that is having the family of the C6000, and here the TMS is the name of the company, Texas Instruments, that is the code. And so this block diagram represents that block diagram of the TMS320C6713 6713 DSK board here. Now the physical appearance of this board it looks like something in this manner. That is, whatever we have described in the block diagram, if we see it physically, then it looks like something in this manner. That is, having the ports here, the microphone input here, the line input, that is stereo input, and the line output, stereo output here, and headphone output, that is the stereo here. And at the same time, another ports are available here, that is the DC power input, USB port, and DIP switches, LED, and the reset switch here. And all the parts are the peripherals, like the CPLD, etc. They are here, and this is the codec here, AIC23 codec. So all parts are represented in this physical layout also here. Here we can see that this is the main processor, that is the DSP, having the speed of the 220 megahertz here. This is the 10 MB SDRAM here, and this is the flash memory. And this is the FPGA here, and this is the CPLD. These are connected through the EMIF to the DSP processor, that is the external memory interface here. So these are the the block diagrams as well as the physical layout of the TMS320C6713 DSK board. As we have discussed during the time of the discussion of the block diagram, that the functional overview may be described something like in this manner, that the interfaces to onboard peripherals through the 32-bit wide, that is the external memory interface, and the SDRAM flash and CPLD are connected to this EMIF bus. EMIF signals are also connected data card expansion, having the memory expansion facilities, and the DSP interfaces to analog audio signals through an onboard AIC23 codec, and four 3.5 mm audio jacks, that is the microphone input, line output, and headphone output. Now, a programmable logic device named as the CPLD is used to implement glue logic that ties the board components together. The main function of the CPLD is to implement the glue logic, and it ties the board components all together here. The DSK includes four LED and a four position DIP switches as a simple way to provide the user with interactive feedback here. And Code Composer Studio communicates with the DSK through an embedded JTAG emulator with a host interface using the USB port. Yeah. So these two ports will be utilized by the Code Composer Studio. And now we have also discussed that the programming of the TMS320C6713, it has the basically four steps. One is the design, second is the code and building, the third one is the debugging, and the fourth one is the analyzing. First, we have to design, that is the conceptual planning is required, and then coding and the building, that is the we have to create the project, write the source code, and then we have to configure the files. After that, debugging, that is the syntax checking, probe points, logging, etc. take place. And then analysis, that is the analyze, real-time debugging statistics tracing here. And at any stage, if there is a need of the modification, then naturally we will move towards the previous step here in order to get the required modification here. So here, in order to interface our designed algorithm to the target, there is a need of the ID, that is CC. We are using here the CCS, Code Composer Studio, and Code Composer Studio provides an ID to incorporate the software tools. CCS includes tools for code generation such as C. So here, whatever the C compiler, so there is a C compiler, and C compiler converts this C file, that is the C code, into the .asm file. And there are the compiler, assembler, and linker. So that C compiler compiles the C code program with the extension of the .c to the .asm, and the assembler accepts the .asm source file and it converts it into the .obj. And the linker combines object files and the object libraries as input to produce an executable file with extension of the .out. And this executable .out file can be loaded and run directly on the C6713 processor. We have discussed these concepts in the previous class, that is yesterday here. Now we will consider some example here. Suppose we consider the Code Composer Studio example. The CCS is the TI's ID that provides a transition between a high-level DSP program and an onboard machine language program. So, and it is used for to generate here the program for the C6713 DSP using the C language, and to load them into the DSK and then run them and monitor the program execution. These are the purposes for which it is used. And the Code Composer Studio, first, during the time of the use of the Code Composer Studio, what are the steps that are required? Make sure DSK is connected to the PC. DSK that we have described in the previous slides, that is the Digital Signal Processor Starter Kit, it is connected to the PC via the USB and to power outlet before opening the CCS here. So before opening this, we have to check whether the DSK is connected to the PC through the USB port and the power port or not here. Then after this, open the CCS by double clicking on the CCS icon, and CCS icon will be something like in this manner. On your computer monitor, you will see this icon here, and when you will double click on this one, then it will be open. And to connect to the DSK, go to the debug, and we will select here the debug file, and then from the debug, we will scroll down and we will select here the connect here. And after this one, we have to start.
Hello. Hello.
डिस्कनेक्ट हो गए थे ना, फोन आ गया था
बीच में, प्लीज डिस्कनेक्ट हो गए।
हाँ, ऑफिस से फोन आ गया था, कोई रिपोर्ट बना के देना था। देवचंद जी, देखिए इरफान का फोन स्विच ऑफ है क्या, एक मिनट आप लगाइए।
ठीक है, मैं एक बार चेक कर ले रहा हूँ।
ठीक है, तो फिर हम लोग क्या कर रहे हैं, वी आर जस्ट डिस्क्राइबिंग हियर द कोड कंपोजर स्टूडियो एंड फॉर इन ऑर्डर टू गेट द कनेक्शन विद द कोड कंपोजर स्टूडियो, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी हैव टू मेक श्योर दैट डीएसके इज कनेक्टेड टू पीसी वाया यूएसबी एंड टू पावर आउटलेट बिफोर ओपनिंग द सीसीएस एंड when we double click on the icon of the CCS, then we have to connect it by selecting the debug and then scroll down and select here the connect. And to start a new project, we will select the project file and scroll down from that one, we will select here the new. And then choose appropriate DSP family. Here we will select the DSP family, that is the TMS320C67 family here. And then we will here click finish here. Now, Code Composer Studio, we have to add here the C source file. So here add the C source file. For example, there is any file that has the extension of the .c. For example, we have taken the example of the dsplab.c here. Add a linker command, .cmd. There is a linker command, add a linker command .cmd and linker command file sets up the memory map for the CCS linker to make sure the code and data are loaded to the desired locations. Linker command file it sets up the memory map for the CCS linker to make sure the code and data are loaded to the desired locations. Add the runtime support library functions, file rts6700.lib to the project here. We have to add the library file. This is the library file that is the runtime support library function that has the runtime support library functions here. And it is named as the rts6700.lib, that is library. Again repeating that in order to add the runtime support library functions, we have to add the file that is the rts6700.lib to the project here. So after adding this file, we have to compile the code, and for the compiling the code, we select the project and then compile the file, and then we have to build the project, and then again we will select the project and select here the build, and we have to load program to DSK, then we will select here the file, and from the file we will select here the load program, and we will choose dot out file in the debug folder, and then run the program on the DSP, and then from the debug select here the run, so the here the program will be run and executed here. So debugging features, what are the debugging features? The setting breakpoints and watching variables, viewing memory, registers, missed C and the assembly code. As we have discussed in the previous lecture, that there is a provision of developing the code having the missed C and the assembly code in order to avoid the do loop time here. Because the do loop time consumes more than 90% time execution time. So here the do loops are written in the assembly code and another codes are written in the C language here. So, and the do loops are near about 10% of the total, near about the 10% of the total program. Hence we can enhance the here the programming of the our system. And the graphing results and monitoring execution time are also the features of the debugging. One can step through a program in different ways, like the step into, over, or the out here. Now, useful sub folders, as we have added the some file like the RTS dot lib file here. There are some useful sub folders are the directories. My projects, a folder that supplied for your projects here. In the my projects, we can get here the projects here. And bin contains many utilities here. The docs contains the documentation and the manuals. And the C6000/CG tools, it contains code generation tools. And C6000 are the RTDX. It contains support files for real-time data transfer. And C6000/BIOS, it contains support file for the DSP BIOS. And examples are they contain the examples included with the CCS. And the tutorials contains additional examples supplied with the CCS here. Now I have just give trying to give you some assignment. You people just try to see some examples and try to write if possible. It is not mandatory, but if possible, then try to write the C program and simulate using this kit, because the kit is not available with you. So you people just try to write down the first flow chart, develop the flow chart, and then if possible, write the C programs also. That is related to the linear convolution, circular convolution, and DFT, and the here the to find the difference equation of the given system here. So if possible, you can do, then please try to do it. Okay, it is not mandatory, but for the practice, if you are interested, then you should try for it. So this is about the today's lecture, that in which we have discussed the concepts of the DSK along with the board layout, and we had also discussed the CCS, what is the Code Composer Studio, what is the role features, and we have also considered here the example how the using the Code Composer Studio, how any program will be downloaded on the given target, that is the TMS320C6713. So this is about the today's lecture, and if you people have any problem, then please go for it.